What is up? It's your boy Steven from DareToCapture, and welcome to another video. In this video, I'm gonna talk about perspective in photography. I'm gonna talk about what perspective is and how you can use perspective to your advantage to help improve your photography skills, no matter what type of picture you're trying to get. For starters, we need to discuss exactly what perspective is. So perspective, when it comes to photography, is basically showing a three-dimensional world in a two-dimensional space. It allows you to see something 3D in a 2D setting. The relationship between all the objects and elements in your photos is what is gonna show what kind of perspective you have as well. And this is why composition is such an extremely vital part of photography, because it helps show what kind of perspective your viewer is gonna be looking at. Now, there are two different ways that you can show perspective in photography. One way is from a physical standpoint, and the other is from a conceptual standpoint. Firstly, we're gonna discuss perspective from a physical standpoint. Now, when I mention this, it's gonna be something that's very easy to do. It's something that not a lot of people think of, but the further along you go on a photography journey with your camera, the more you're gonna understand how easy it is to actually change perspective from a physical standpoint. Now, when it comes to photography, especially when it comes to beginners, a lot of them fall into the habit of just taking a regular eye level photo. They see the photo they want and they just take that photo from eye level. Now, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with taking this typical eye level photo, but in the end, it's something that everyone always sees. It's something that's not really different from what the typical person sees on a daily basis. So even though these eye level photos aren't a bad thing, it's not gonna add anything different to your photos. You're not gonna stand out in any way. It's not gonna add anything dynamic to your photos. Your photos are eventually gonna turn out to be a little boring no matter what you try to add to it if you're not changing perspective from at least a physical standpoint. The viewers are gonna be seeing the same type of view over and over and over again. So instead, if you see a photo that you wanna take, instead of taking it from a regular eye level, switch things up. Try to get a little lower, get a little higher, change the distance that you are from the subject itself. Doing these little things, changing your actual physical position and changing where the camera is, the angle of the camera relative to the subject, is gonna add a completely different perspective from a physical standpoint. You'd be surprised at just how moving a few feet in any direction can really change how your photo looks. Small changes can make a massive difference in how your photo turns out. So don't be scared to change things up. Don't be scared to change things around. Sometimes you might find that these different angles you're working on aren't gonna work out, but at least you change something so that you're not getting a typical regular eye level shot. Now again, it's important to remember that the eye level shot isn't something that's bad. It's gonna be something that most people see more often than not. So anything you can do to change that up, even just a little bit, is gonna take your photography skills to the next level. Now we're gonna move on to perspective from a conceptual standpoint. Now most of the time you're physically gonna be able to move around no matter what type of picture you're trying to get. You're gonna be able to move yourself, you're gonna be able to move your camera, but there's probably gonna be some occasions where you can't actually move around, you don't have the luxury of moving your camera. So this is where the concept of your photos might need to change a little bit. Being able to change the concept of your photos when you can't move around or you can't move your camera is gonna be vital, because when you're unable to do this, you don't wanna be stuck having the same exact type of photo every single time you press the shutter button. So for example, one simple way of changing a concept in your photo is to show distance from a subject. So say I'm taking a picture of mountains in the distance. A good way to change the perspective from a conceptual standpoint is to show the ground in the photo. Show the ground that is right by your feet. And when you see the distance between your feet and the actual mountain, you're gonna see how far that distance actually is. You're not gonna be stuck in just seeing mountains in the distance, not knowing exactly how far away they are. Even though you're not gonna know the exact distance from your feet to the mountains, it's gonna show the audience a great perspective, because you're gonna be able to see your feet and you're gonna see how far the ground actually goes until you actually reach the mountains. Another way to change perspective from a conceptual standpoint is to have different focal lengths for your photos. So if you take a regular eye level photo, take multiple pictures, but have each picture be a different focal length so that there's a bit of a different perspective. It's gonna look like you're standing closer or further away, even though you're standing in the same exact spot. A simple change in focal length is gonna be able to show a much different perspective of a certain subject, regardless of how much different that focal length actually is. So this is why if you have the luxury of getting a zoom lens, take advantage of that. You're able to change perspective much easier and there's gonna be a lot less problems. You aren't gonna have to change lenses every time you wanna change a bit of perspective from your photo. You can stand in the same spot, rotate the lens a little bit, and you're gonna have a different perspective no matter what. If you don't have the luxury of having a zoom lens, then you might need to make sure you have at least a few different types of lenses so that you can change that focal length from a conceptual standpoint. When you have different lenses, yes, the process is gonna be a little longer when you're trying to take photos because you're having to change out each lens every time you wanna take a different photo from a different focal length. But in the end, every lens is gonna offer you something different, so every lens is gonna be able to offer you a different perspective. Another way to change perspective from a conceptual standpoint is to completely change the composition of your photo. Now, composition is something that is extremely important in any photo you take, so when you're able to change just a few things about that composition, you're gonna be able to change the perspective of that photo entirely. So for example, you can have a picture with a few different subjects standing out in your photo, but if you take away some of those subjects and change that composition completely, the same photo isn't gonna look anywhere near the same. So that small change in composition is really gonna give you a completely different perspective on the photo. Another way to change your perspective when you can is to add in leading lines to your photos. Leading lines are gonna help draw the viewer's eyes to a specific point in your photo. So when you can do this, you're gonna be able to show a very specific perspective for that photo. It's natural for us to look at a photo and for our eyes to just jump all over the picture because it's trying to find a specific subject to look at. When you have leading lines, your eyes and your brain have a lot less work to do because the photo does all the work for you. The leading lines lead your eyes to exactly where you want the person's eyes to look. And trust me, when you give the viewer much less work to do with their eyes and their brain, they're gonna enjoy your photo much better. There's one more thing that you can do to change your perspective from a conceptual standpoint, and that's called forced perspective. This concept is another one that involves distance. The best example I can think of this is having a photo where it looks like a person is holding up an entire building. Obviously, the person's not gonna be able to hold up an entire building, but because of the distance they are from the building and the angle you took your photo, their hands look like they're actually holding up the building themselves. And because of this, you're forcing the viewer to see what you want them to see. Forced perspective is something that's gonna cause the viewer to actually question what they're actually seeing because it's something that usually isn't natural for people to see. How often have you actually seen a person lift up an entire building? My guess is never. That forced perspective tricks the brain into thinking what you want it to think, so you should take advantage of this situation when you can. So when it comes to perspective, there are a ton of different things that you can actually do to change the perspective of your photos. You need to keep in mind though, that when you change the perspective, you're also changing the composition, so multiple things might have to change when you're changing that perspective. So even if you feel like you've taken the perfect photo, don't be scared to take that same photo again, but from a different perspective and see how it turns out. You might be surprised at how much more you like that initial perfect photo because you changed the perspective just a little bit. Hey, you might even end up not liking the perspective that you changed to, but in the end, it's good that you even tried to change things around so that you're not having the same typical boring photos over and over and over again. Understanding perspective and changing things up from time to time is only going to improve your photography skills in the end. I'm not saying you always have to change perspective, but keep in mind that a change of perspective is going to be refreshing for the viewer, and it's probably going to be refreshing for you when you look back at the photos that you've taken. So be sure to hit that like button. I know if you made it this far in the video, you probably ended up liking it, so you might as well help me out by hitting that thumbs up. If you have any other great ideas about how you think you can change the perspective of a photo, I would love to see those in the comments below. And if you haven't already, be sure to hit that subscribe button because you don't want to miss any future Dare to Capture videos. So on that note, I'm Steven. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.